You tweet about climate change after extreme weather events all the time, and each time it makes climate change deniers freak out. Is this your strategy?
Well, I just want to remind voters that suppose you had somebody running for congressional office in your district who insisted that there's no connection between cigarette smoking and cancer. Would you vote for that person? I mean, you might, but if this person were adamant, no, the scientists who studied cigarette smoking, they don't know what they're, if they were adamant, would you vote for them? And so in the same way, the connection between climate change and human activity is at least as strong as cigarettes and cancer. And so I just want everybody to keep this in mind, that it's very reasonable that the floods in Texas, the strengthening storms, especially the president was in Florida, these things are a result of human activity making things worse. Now, it's very bad. I get you this, that people have died in Texas. But reminding you what else, this is very expensive business. When you flood the fourth largest city in the United States, somebody's going to pay for it. And it's you and me. And so the sooner we get to work on climate change, the better. And people say to me, Carol, Bill, they say, Nye, what can I do about climate change? And what I say nowadays is talk about it. If we were talking about climate change the same way we talked about the stuff that goes on, let's say, in Ferguson or Baltimore, if we were talking about it, those are very serious issues, to be sure. But if we were talking about climate change in the same way, we'd be doing something about it. And then I, you know, was born in the U.S.
Right, right.
I'm an engineer from the U.S. My engineering license is in the U.S. And so I want the U.S. to lead the world. I don't want the U.S. to wait for other countries to start coming up with the new technologies, the new regulations that we're going to need.